Tesla has had a few challenging months. I think it's very fair to say that. I mean, what with their factory in China being essentially shut down for nearly 2 months, then Gigafactory Berlin having all the holdups and, you know, part shortages, etc. But now it looks like things are starting to turn for Tesla. Here is yet another reason why Tesla will beat expectations this year, in my view, and why right now the stock is literally a very, very good price. But don't take my word for that. I'll just keep on buying more while everyone else keeps selling. Hello, my friends, and welcome. Channel on the Electric Viking, coming to you here from Melbourne, Australia. Norway. Well, you know what? Isn't Norway such a brilliant example of the electric revolution? You know what? If you're from Norway, you guys should be holding your heads. You know, don't walk around with your head down. You guys should be walking around with your heads up, because what you have done there with the electric revolution has been truly staggering, absolutely amazing. Norway has done so much to lead Europe into a cleaner, better future. So huge kudos to them. Now, what about Tesla? Well, after two kind of slow months, they're making a pretty big splash in Norway this month with high volume deliveries of the Model Y. According to the internet, close to 2,000 new Tesla Model Ys were registered so far this month as of the 25th of June. So that's in, well, it looks like around about 4 weeks, 2,000 were delivered, so 500 per week. That's two times more than the number of Volkswagen ID.4 registrations during those 4 weeks. Now, this news is quickly picked up by Tesla's enthusiastic media, but there's some other interesting information going on here in Norway as well. Now, as you know, ID.4 and ID.3, they have been struggling a little bit in Europe because, well, ramp up is difficult. It's not easy, is it? However, the trio of the Volkswagen ID.4 with 1,000 deliveries, the Skoda Enyaq with 800, and the Audi Q4 with 328, that's the e-tron electric version, by the way, had a total of 2,143 units. That's more than the Model Y, of course, if you put those three vehicles together, but pretty close, 2,143 versus 2,000. But it's showing what type of cars are popular in Norway, and that's what I've been talking about on this channel quite a lot. They are crossovers and SUVs, not sedans or hatchbacks. The Tesla Model Y had only 14 deliveries. Now, that might be thanks to Tesla's delivery schedule from their China factory, I would assume, though. The top six for January the 1st to June the 25th, though, are the Tesla Model Y with 5,607 deliveries, the Volkswagen ID.4 with 4,174, Skoda Enyaq with 2,900, Hyundai Ioniq 5, 2,700, BMW iX 2,600, and the Audi Q4 e-tron with 2,587. So as you can see, the Model Y had actually fallen behind until this month in Norway, but this latest surge has enabled to strengthen its position as the number one selling vehicle in Norway. Now, I believe it actually could be the number one selling car worldwide next year, and I didn't used to think that was possible. Elon said that that might happen, and I thought, nah, I don't think so. However, I just made a video showing you the top 10 best-selling vehicles worldwide last year in 2021. And frankly, when you look at the numbers and you start to realize Tesla's production this year, realize the trends that are going on, it's actually very possible. Now, if you haven't seen that video, you should check that out. I'll put a link to that video in the description below. The other thing that's interesting here too is seeing Volkswagen's kind of resurgence. Now, they have had a very difficult year this year. The media hasn't been telling you the truth because, frankly, Volkswagen sales are down versus Q3 and Q4 of last year, which, seeing as they don't have any factories in Shanghai, there doesn't seem to be any real good reason for it. Now, if you put their sales together, though, the ID.4, the Enyaq, Q4 e-tron, then together they have 9,660 registrations in Norway, which is pretty impressive. Now, Inside EV says that while many contenders appeared on the market, the EV king of Norway remains the same with a big advantage over other models. According to the stats, the number of registered Nissan Leaf cars exceeded 74,000, which is a combination of more than 10 years on the market and consistent three-digit monthly sales results. Now, to be fair, Nissan Leaf sales are pretty low right now in Norway. That figure is largely due to their sales over the last 10 years. But it is interesting to have a look at this chart. Number one, in terms of vehicles on the roads in Norway is the Nissan Leaf with 74,000, number two. Volkswagen e-Golf with 48,000, number three. The Tesla Model 3 with 37,000. I'm surprised at that because it hasn't even been on sale for that long. I mean, compare it to the Leaf, which has been on sale there for 10 years. Anyhow, number four is the BMW i3 with 30,558. And then number five is the Audi e-tron with 24,000. The Tesla Model Y at 13,875 is still in its early stages. It hasn't been on sale there for that long compared to the Leaf. And only slightly ahead of the Volkswagen ID4 with 12,894. But I think that with their production at their factory in China ramping up enormously by the 7th of August this year, to the point where China will be hitting 22,500 vehicles produced per week from their factory there, and also the ramp up of Tesla Model Y production in Germany, I think we're going to see a lot more Model Ys being sold in Norway this year. It's going to be interesting to see how long it will take for, say, the Model 3 or the Model Y to get first place over and above the Nissan Leaf in Norway. I'm going to guess still a few years away. To complete the comparison, the trio of Volkswagen ID4, Enyaq, and Audi Q4 e-tron together has 27,715 units driving around on Norwegian roads. That's enough to put it 10,000 behind the Model 3 by itself. Isn't this a fascinating study, right, of what happens in a country where they embrace the future, right? The number one car driving around on Norwegian roads is an electric car. So really, there's not that many polluting cars left in Norway. Wouldn't it be amazing? Today, I was driving around in my car. I wind the window down. I can just smell the stink of diesel and petrol fumes everywhere. Got to wind it up again. In Australia here, I mean, we're a big country. We don't have that many people, but this is still common everywhere. Imagine in Norway, right? You get a lot of wind in Norway. And in addition to that, most cars there are now either hybrids or electric, meaning wind your window down in Norway, you're probably going to smell nothing but clean air. That is a future I can't wait for. I'm genuinely really excited for that. And it's going to be so great when, you know, our kids, when they're our age, they wind down their window, no matter where they are, big cities, small cities, you know, industrial complexes, whatever it may be, they don't have to breathe in toxic air. They can just drive along and not even think about it. I'm looking forward to that future. I hope you are too. Thank you for watching.